Toxoplasmosis is one of the most common parasitic infections throughout the world. According to one estimate from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, up to one quarter of Americans may be infected, and one third of the world's population. But you might not know you have the disease, which typically has no symptoms. However, to people with compromised immune systems and pregnant women, it can be deadly. Humans become infected with toxoplasmosis by ingesting food and water contaminated with oocysts from infected cat feces, or by ingesting tissue cysts in raw meat from infected animals. At the National Institute for Mathematical and Biological Synthesis, Dr. Xiaopeng Zhu is co-organizer of a workshop in which a multidisciplinary group of scientists will study Toxoplasma gondii, the parasite that causes infection.
This is the first workshop on mathematical modeling of T. gondii. This workshop is different than other meetings of toxoplasmosis in that we are trying to address a number of interdisciplinary questions that require close collaborations between biologists and theorists, mathematicians.
Scientists say T. gondii is a great model for studying other parasites because it is easy to culture in the lab. Knowledge gained from T. gondii studies can also benefit the study of other parasitic infections, like malaria.
T. gondii is a classical representation of a family of multi-host parasites known as Epicomplexa, which consists of 4,600 species. T. gondii has been considered as an excellent model for Epicomplexa because it is easy to culture and manipulate in the lab.
T. gondii poses an interesting mathematical problem because of its genetic diversity and because of its clonal expansion. Dr. Zhao explains.
T. gondii has very high genetic diversity. Hundreds of genotypes have been identified globally. However, only one lineage is widespread and predominant in the world's population. This phenomenon is known as clonal expansion. Mathematical tools such as evolutionary dynamics can provide a possible explanation for why this specific lineage become widespread and become dominant.
For more information about workshops and programs at the interface between mathematics and biology, visit our website at www.nimbus.org.